The format, layout, and content of a Dataview report are determined by a Dataview template. A template enables you to view measurement data recorded on your AEMC instrument and downloaded and saved on your PC. The template controls which data appears in the report and how this data is presented. The Dataview software comes with a number of predefined templates. Each of these is designed to be used for a specific instrument control panel and purpose. You can use these templates as is or modify them to suit your requirements. You can also create new templates from scratch. This video is an introduction to Dataview template design. In this video, we will explain how to perform the simple modification of adding a customized logo to the template cover sheet. Although this is a relatively quick and cosmetic change, it should help provide some background for future videos that will discuss more extensive template customization topics. Before you begin, Dataview must be installed on your PC. The logo you want to add to your template should also be stored as a file on your computer. This isn't a strict requirement. You can create a logo on the fly, as we explain a little later in this video. However, it will help you follow along with our instructions. To begin, click the Dataview icon on your desktop. After a few moments, Dataview opens with the Quick Start dialog box displayed. Close this dialog box. Click File in the menu bar at the top of the screen, and then click Open. Then click the option Open Template. This displays the Open dialog box. Select the directory associated with the instrument control panel to which this template applies. In this example, we will choose the PEL directory. The templates available for the instrument are listed. If the template you want to modify does not appear in this list, you can browse your computer's directories to locate it. After the template is selected, click Open. The template now appears on the screen, displaying sample data. We can now modify this template. Click the tab at the bottom of the screen, labeled Cover Sheet. This displays the first page of the template. By default, this contains identification information, such as the time and date of the recording session displayed, the operator who conducted the session, the site location where the recording took place, and other information. In the lower right corner of the cover sheet is the logo for AEMC instruments. Many customers may choose to replace this with their own company logo. To do this, click the AEMC logo to highlight it, and then press the Delete key. This should remove the logo. To add your own logo, click Frame in the menu bar, and then click Place OLE. Your cursor should now change to the Place OLE cursor. Note that you can also do this by clicking the OLE icon in the toolbar. Position the cursor at the spot on the cover sheet where you want to insert your custom logo. This must be within the margins of the cover sheet page, which are defined by dotted gray lines. The location must also allow sufficient room for your logo's image. You cannot resize the image once it is placed in Dataview, so it will appear the same size as it does outside Dataview. For example, the AEMC logo that we are replacing in this template is approximately 106 by 32 pixels. Use this as a guide for sizing your logo before placing it in Dataview. When you have selected an appropriate spot with the Place OLE cursor, click on it. The Insert Object dialog box appears. This presents a list of different object types you can add to the template. You can create a new template on the fly, or select a previously created one. Note that if you create the object at this time, the application with which you create the object should also be available on all computers that subsequently view this report. Otherwise, the object may not be viewable. In this example, we will place an existing logo, so choose the Create from File option. Then specify the file name where the logo is stored, or use the Browse button to locate the file. When the name is entered into the file field, click OK. Your company logo now appears in the report at the Place OLE cursor position. You can fine-tune its placement by clicking on the logo and dragging it to the final location while holding down the left button on your mouse. The final step is to save the modified template. Note that you cannot save the modified file under its original name. This prevents you from changing the standard Dataview templates that ship with the product. Instead, you must save the modified template under its own new name. Click File in the menu bar, and then click Save as Template. This displays the Save As dialog box. Go to the appropriate directory, and then enter the name of the template, ensuring that its file extension is DVT. This allows Dataview to recognize the file as a template and display it among the list of available templates for the Pell control panel. By default, DVT files are stored in the templates subdirectory in the Dataview directory. You can now use this revised template to generate future Dataview reports. This concludes our explanation for how to add a custom logo to your Dataview templates. Future videos will describe in detail how to perform more extensive template customization and redesign. Please check our YouTube channel for additional instructional videos about Dataview and all other AEMC products.